Hello everyone, my name is Vaibhav Vijay Gupta. This is the first time I'm trying to do this kind of a video, so please bear with me. As you can see here, NVIDIA yesterday tweeted a very interesting news in the technology world. NVIDIA is going to acquire ARM for $40 billion. They are going to create biggest company both in terms of mobile computing and artificial intelligence. NVIDIA is an American tech company, is a leader in producing GPU related products. Most of their products are used in gaming, films, animations. In past couple of years, they have covered up a lot of ground in terms of artificial intelligence. Some experts also believe that in terms of artificial innovation, NVIDIA has approximately 80% of the market share. 80%, let that point sink in. 80% is a huge number. On the other hand, ARM is the world leader in semiconductor IP or intellectual property company, with almost 70% of world's population uses its architecture when it comes to smartphones. Almost all Chinese smartphone manufacturers use ARM based processors. If you have, or if you are watching this video on any of the Android devices, probably you are using ARM inside. Even Apple is using ARM for making its processor, for now at least. Even I think the new Apple 12 will have the ARM, but in the future Apple want to move on to their own chip silicon. So for now Apple seems to be safe, but just for now. So why do I think this deal is happening now? There were some rumors going around in the tech community that this is going to happen. I think the number one reason it happened is because SoftBank, which was the holding company for the ARM, had a couple of bad years in terms of financial success. COVID pandemic has worsened their situation. SoftBank mostly made their investment into ride-sharing companies like Uber, which again is in trouble. And last year, WeWork was a total flop show. They want to sell ARM for a good value. The second reason this might be happening is US want to raise their stake into tech market, or rather US government want to maintain its supremacy in the tech market. At the same time, it is a reply towards the Chinese push to gain upper hand in the technology sector. Most of the Android manufacturers at the moment are Chinese companies. So yeah, Chinese were capturing a lot of market, and US was like gaining the upper hand in the technology is one of the reasons that this deal is good for US in general. So what can China do? That comes another question when you hear this news. First of all, let me clarify one thing. This move is like they have announced it, but it is not completed yet. There are several regulations that has to be met with US government, with UK government, with Japanese government, because SoftBank is from Japan, and the Chinese government. If Chinese government wants, and I think it is in their best interest, it can refuse great hurdles in the completion of this deal. Second thing is there is an open source competitor for ARM, that is RISC-V. Most experts say it is next ARM. Chinese company, big Chinese company like Alibaba and Huawei are the member of RISC-V. In case if this deal completes, this RISC-V will likely profit the most. Chinese government will again have something that they can use in their mobile, and I think they will be able to hold on to a lot of the mobile computing market. So what does this all mean for the end user, just like you and me? Gamers, filmmakers, animators can get their hand on cheaper and better GPUs. A few more competitors will emerge into this computing market. It will benefit the end customer. So does that mean mobiles will get cheaper in the future? I don't think so. But what can happen? NVIDIA starts making processor with higher graphical performance for mobiles, especially. The gaming scenario on the mobile has skyrocketed. Like, so many people are now playing games on mobile. Another thing that can happen is, like, recently NVIDIA launched their RTX 3000 series graphic cards. Better performance on the ray tracing. So maybe ray tracing will come to mobile games, who knows. Like already Xbox has announced like there will be ray tracing games, so consoles will be benefited, handheld consoles like Nintendo Shift. So if someone is gaining, then someone must be losing, right? Who are the companies or people that are losing? I think there are three of them. AMD is one, Intel, and definitely on some level Qualcomm. So let me explain it one by one. AMD recently started producing good processor for desktop and started competing with Intel. But they were also trying to, like we all know, AMD has a Radeon series, so they also make graphic card. But again, as I said, RTX 3000 series GPUs were launched, and on the paper they provide a very good value. So again, AMD's push might get a, you know, setback. Mobile gaming is on the rise. So yeah, Nvidia played a very good hand by snatching ARM. Kudos to them. What about the Intel? Like Intel tried to get into the mobile computing scenario, but they are still not the major player. Qualcomm has the monopoly for now. Even Qualcomm uses the ARM architecture. Might be a lot of competition is coming for the Qualcomm. What I personally think is that this deal has both upside and downside. Upside can be more computing and graphical power in your handheld devices, mobile and consoles like Nintendo Shift. Few manufacturers are already making gaming mobiles. Downside can be like, we all know Nvidia likes to dominate the market. They already are dominating GPU market. This is another opportunity for Nvidia to start another monopoly on mobile gaming and mobile computing. So that is it for me today. If you like this video, give me a like. If you didn't like this video, the other button also works fine. Do not forget to comment on this matter down in the comment section. If you really liked it, consider sharing, subscribing, and hitting that notification bell to watch similar content in the future. Thanks for watching.